features. I was like, subtitles. I'm like,
hello and welcome. Surprise. To the Game of Chance 2-1 podcast number 28. 28. We're going to be at 30 really soon. Maybe I will do that gameplay thing that I did for 10. Yeah. But for 20, I was just like, nah, screw it. But it took like, and like, I recorded like 2 hours of me just running around Assassin's Creed. And I just sat and listened to a podcast. But I had to do like a certain editing so that it wouldn't capture me listening to the podcast, because normally it captures desktop sound, whatever. Anyways, we are an entertainment podcast that talks mostly about PlayStation, Destiny, superheroes, movie, TV, mostly TV, but all of our shows are done. So,
yep. So now it's mostly video games. So.
Yeah, now it's mostly just gaming news and Destiny. And comics and stuff, sometimes. Yeah, sometimes. So yeah, all sorts of nerdy things if you're into that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So Eric is wearing his Indianapolis Colts shirt today for the audio listeners. Oh snap! Got stuck on your chin, dude. I need a Colts shirt that like actually fits me.
I'm gonna blindside you with this question. What did you have for dinner?
Pizza.
Pizza. I had Olive Garden because today was my sister's graduation and we went out for Olive Garden.
Olive Garden.
I had the Italy tour. It had like lasagna, chicken parmesan, and chicken Alfredo. It was pretty good.
Team bro. Fat. Team fat. Holy crap. I just had like 2 pieces of pizza. I need to step up my game. You're just having a feast over there. Dang.
Yeah, it was good.
And not to mention the unlimited breadsticks. Yeah.
Yes.
So it's all of that plus the breadsticks. When I go to Olive Garden,
too.
I basically get breadsticks and then a side dish.
No. Yeah.
But it's I legitimately eat more
like
breadsticks than I do my main dish.
Dude, every time I go to Olive Garden, it's usually I eat some breadsticks, maybe some of the appetizer. Eat some of my food, and then I look at dessert. Oh, I really wish I had room to eat that.
And you never do.
And no one has dessert there.
Yeah, I do that too. Like, a lot of times when we go out to eat, I'll look at the dessert menu and be like, oh man, that looks really good.
I might
there's
say
no way I'm getting that.
Yeah, there's no way.
There's no way that's happening.
I have to be like, okay, I need to look at the desserts first so I can see how much I can eat.
That should be my goal. Go out somewhere, eat a decent meal, and actually get dessert. That's my team fat goal of the year.
Get some fried ice cream, dude. It's great.
Oh, I've had that before. It's so freaking good. But the last time I had it was like, I was in like second grade or something. I don't know. I was really young.
It's really good, though.
Yeah, they have it.
Slan.
I had it at like a Mexican
restaurant. Mexican restaurants also sell flan, which is like a really... It's kind of like a weird cheesecake, but it's not cheesecake.
Cheesecake's
good.
It's
very sweet, too.
I haven't had cheesecake in a long time. Anyways, we also talk about desserts sometimes. So, what have we been playing in the last week? I think I started last time, so Eric. I might be completely wrong about that.
It doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter what your name is! Just do it!
What have I been playing? I played some Fallout New Vegas in celebration of a certain thing that we're going to talk about.
Dude, my water bottle is super transparent today. Holy
oh my gosh,
crap.
So is mine.
What? Rop. Sorry, I drank from it, and sometimes you can see like a shade of it because it's not completely green. But today I was drinking, and I was like, I can't see anything here. I'm just drinking from the air. Go on.
I played some Agario. I've played some Team Fortress 2, of all things. One of the guys in a Facebook group I'm in, he plays a lot of Steam games on his Alienware laptop, and he's like, hey, add me on Steam, and we played some TF2, so that's cool.
Yeah, Eric skipped out on us on Destiny all week, so he was just playing PC.
Work. I got a job, actually. What was it? I don't know.
Oh, he's getting that money!
The YouTube money.
he's working at the YouTube headquarters.
Yeah. Nah, I just got a job at the store near where I live, and it's like really putting me off on like Destiny for some reason. I don't know why, but I mean, I enjoyed Trials the other night. It was fun, but
Trials.
The normal grind, getting on, doing some bounties. It's just.
Oh no! You don't have to do that. We just wanted you to play when we wanted to play Prison or Trials, and you're like, nah.
See, I wasn't feeling Prison either. I don't know.
Yeah. GG. What was I gonna say? The night that Eric did play with us one night, which was Friday.
You wrecked.
We did insanely well.
Less than 45 minutes.
It was like one of my favorite times playing games in forever. And then the next night was like one of my worst times playing games.
Who did you guys play with?
J Money,
yeah.
It was awful. It was
awful.
It was the worst. Like by the end, we were getting all mad at each other, and it was
oh my gosh,
it was awful.
We've had the synergy with us.
I went to sleep literally frowning. Oh. I was like, I really never go to sleep angry, mate. Well, what was I gonna do? You sent me a picture or a video of like kittens meowing and all over the place, like, no, and I literally was watching it like this. You can't see it, but people in the just like straight, just dead. Grim. Dead on. It killed me. I was dead on the inside. My heart, my soul, my joy, it was all gone.
Your Thanks joints. A lot, Your joints. Took all my it's joints. All gone. Dead. My joints.
I was limp on the floor, paralyzed because I don't have any more joints. Why are you holding up an acorn?
This is the same pine cone, dude.
Oh, pineco. Why did I call it an acorn? What is wrong with it?
Because it was shaped like a
acorn,
I guess.
Why do you still have
it? I still have it. It's just sitting back here.
Wasn't that the random object that you used to close out like the first
throwback,
episode?
Throwback here.
That's hilarious, dude.
Yeah, the scented pine cones.
Scented pine cones.
From last fall.
That's awesome.
It doesn't give off much smell, but you have to actually smell it to find the scent. But yeah, I keep it here when I'm angry.
You just sniff a pine cone. You're like,
yeah, when I first started playing Destiny, and I was like really at Crucible, I would just get angry. I'm like, hey, that's nice.
I feel like you're getting high off of the scented pine cone. I feel like that's what's really going on here. It's like the
and I got water everywhere because I laughed. Gosh.
Do like a mini
water everywhere. Blue water everywhere.
Blue water everywhere now. So yeah, I play. That's pretty much all you played, I would assume. Play any more PC things?
Fallout, Team Fortress 2, Destiny, a little.
Play any Minecraft?
Agario, Minecraft. Minecraft, of all things. I'm about to, like, okay, of course, Adventure Capitalist. And, I don't know. Yeah, that's pretty much it, though. Yeah.
Okay.
Just some pick and chooses. I haven't played Witcher in like a week. I'm sad. I want to play it, but then I look at it, I'm like, this could be better.
Eric just really he meant to buy it on PS4.
I got so caught up in like, oh, can I run it on my PC? That'd be so cool. But then I was like, wait, I want the collector's item. I want the app. I want the little notes from the developers and all that, but no, I bought a $60 code for GOG.com at GameStop.
GOG.com. Oh no, I dropped something. Nothing is going on. I'm not pulling anything from my shelf to show later.
So yeah, rip $60. I might just buy it when I get my paycheck. I just because I've seen gameplay on PS4. It looks fine.
It's great. Runs really well. Looks really good. I haven't had any FPS problems at all. Apparently, the Xbox was having a bunch of FPS problems.
Yeah,
I heard that. They patched it. So, you know, like everything in the world that can just be patched, which is everything.
You know, I'm kind
starving,
of like surprised.
Patch it.
Like you know how there's always like big when there's a big problem. Apparently, the developers can just patch it. Yeah. I feel like in some games, you would think, like, oh no, this can't be fixed by just a patch. They would have to, like, give new copies out, but then they would be broke. But, like, that never happens, because apparently it can be done through patches, which is pretty impressive.
Yeah. Yeah, it's super impressive.
Oh, that like... reminds me. You know that game by Bungie named Myth that I talk about a lot?
Yes.
Back then, they didn't have... They couldn't push out patches, and like back in the 90s when that game was popular.
Yeah.
So Bungie was like broke almost because they messed up on one of the games.
Did they have to resend?
They repackaged them. People sent it back. They reimaged the CDs.
That was almost the end of Bungie.
Bungie, we would have never had Destiny.
We could have never had Halo or Destiny. Would have all been out the window.
Oh. But yeah, Halo really brought them into the forefront of gaming. So yeah.
Oh, Bungie.
Some little
you with your little
info.
A history lesson by Eric.
Yeah.
Anyways, what was I gonna say? So what I have been playing. I played a little bit of The Witcher, like always. I played like an hour of The Witcher. Of course, Destiny. No one has yet to get an Elder Cipher.
Yeah, that's true.
Haven't gotten it.
All the YouTubers are getting it, though.
Yeah. What else? I played some Unfinished Swan. Like early in the week, because I still really like that game. That game's awesome. I will get all those trophies one day.
By the way, I think last week... I wasn't paying attention as much in the podcast.
No, you weren't.
No, I wasn't, and it really bothered me.
Around the end.
Because I watched the podcast. I watched like 30 minutes of it. Yeah. I was like, wow, this is really bothering me. Why am I not paying attention? Stop.
Well,
Eric, stop.
We'll talk about what you had to do and why the podcast was up late. We'll talk about that in a minute.
Oh, but what I was going to say is that you said something about Aether 1, and you were like, you didn't like it that much.
No, I didn't.
I'm not sure how far you actually got into it because...
I played for like 3 hours and then was like, this isn't for me.
Yeah, I don't know. It's really interesting. Did you get to the hub or the case?
Yeah.
Did you get into the open world area?
Yep. Yeah. I got down into the mines.
The mines. It's cool when you figure out what to do.
I think I got a little further than the mines and then I was still like...
Yeah. I'm about there. I haven't gotten far, but I liked the system of, like, you can only carry one item, and it's a little puzzler, first-person puzzler. It's a cool little novelty game, but...
Yeah, it was
that's
cool.
That's why I wanted to say that about...
Yeah, it was cool. I just didn't like it. But one day before we streamed, we were waiting on Ryan to get home, so I played two of the PlayStation Plus games. So I played Futuridium EP Deluxe, which is gosh dang awesome. That is a great game, except for one thing. When you die, it's over. It's an arcade
roguelike.
Old school arcade type.
Roguelike.
No, it's not roguelike, as in there's nothing that carries over. It's more of like a permadeath. It's just like, all right, restart from level one. It's like...
Interesting. Kind of like Agario.
Yeah, so similar in that way, where there's not
build up. You did so much work, and then.
But yeah, so that game is awesome. The music is super good. The mechanics are awesome. I like that game a lot. But I was like, if I'm gonna die and just restart, I'm not gonna do this.
Right.
And then I also played that game that we were making fun of last week, Super Exploding Zoo.
Oh.
Is really, really hilarious. That game is so funny more than
any. Exploding Zoo.
That game is freaking hilarious. You're literally kamikaze penguins that, like, you go and collect other penguins and then they're like, and they explode on the monsters. And then crocodiles can, like different animals have different abilities. It's so freaking funny. But I deleted it because I got pretty far in, and I accidentally hit, like, a new game, and it deleted my old game.
Oof, that's gotta be, like, imagine if you did that on, like, I know it doesn't happen, but imagine if you did that on, like, Bloodborne or something. Oof.
Yeah, that'd be rough.
80 hours gone.
That'd be rough. That's why I was like, I don't care enough to keep going, or to restart, so.
I understand, though.
Yeah, what else? I don't think I played Persona at all. Played a little bit of Freedom Wars. Yeah, that was it. That's all I played. Oh, no! Oh my gosh, dude. So, this will tie into a later topic, but I want one of my... I have my two favorite MMOs are WildStar.
ESO.
And Elder Scrolls Online. And...
Honorable mention to WoW for its longevity.
Yeah, and if Destiny counts, then Destiny's number one. But, you know, it doesn't... it counts, but not really.
Not traditional.
But yeah, so WildStar is one of my... Is like, the, you know... I don't know. ESO and WildStar are tied. They're both very different.
Yeah.
WildStar is more just, like, fun. Whereas Elder Scrolls is this really awesome
world. Story-driven. Whatnot, very so. Story-driven. That's what I like about it.
So, yeah. They're very different. But I played... I don't know if I've told this on the podcast before. But I played... I got WildStar at launch because I heard a ton about it. And I was, like, super excited. But and
it's like, poop in terms of optimization and all that stuff.
Well, hold on. There's more to the story. Yes. A lot more. But the... Basically, I heard about the game before it came out. I heard that it was being made by, like, WoW developers, and they were like, our main problem with World of Warcraft is that the combat is super boring. And I was like, I agree. And they're like, here's what we're doing about it. And I was like, yes, this is great. And so I pre-ordered it because I, like, upgraded my graphics card, like, in the past couple of months. So I was like, oh, maybe I can run this. And I pre-ordered it. It came out, and I was at, like, two different camps, like, for, like, 2 weeks. As it came out, like, it came out the first week, and then I had to leave, like, the day it came out. Yeah. So I was gone for, like, 2 weeks, and then I came back, and I had to go take a freaking ACT or whatever. And then I came back from that, and I immediately got on and played for, like, 60 hours in 1 week. And I was like, this is a freaking awesome. And then I continued to play the game for, like, 2 months, and then around, like, the middle of the... early in the third month, and basically I was playing the game the whole time. I was playing the game, I was playing at like 20 FPS, but I loved it so much that I kept playing. But eventually, as I kept playing, like, it just kept taking its toll on me more and more, and I was like, I can't freaking do this. So around the third month, I unsubscribed because I was like, I can't. But it was still the, like, one of the most fun time, and nobody, like, I couldn't get any of my friends to get it. I played with Gabby a little bit, and she liked it decently. I did not play with you because you did not have your computer at the time. That was the problem. What? You had a crappy computer.
Oh well, yeah, back then. But then we played again for like a month.
Exactly, but that wasn't. You know, I'm talking about like launch. Yeah. But we did play a little bit later. But at launch, I couldn't get anyone to play. Nate was like, "Oh, the art style's too cartoony."
And that he was like that, his only complaint. He said that about freaking WoW and everything. Yeah,
he's weird. But we miss you, but you're weird. We're all weird. So yeah, and then I unsubscribed, and I was thinking, I kind of put it out of my mind for a while until Eric got his computer, and I was like, oh yeah, dude, we're totally playing. I don't care if I'm running at 20 FPS. And I still did, but I played anyways. I
was running it at 50 FPS.
Yeah, Eric was like, oh, this is fine for me. I don't know what you're talking about. And I'm like, shut up. But,
It was mostly view distance that was, like, the main impact.
Yeah. But long story short, that game is going free-to-play in the fall. So okay. Like, they made the official announcement and whatnot, so I've been, like, watching this one guy that I really like stream it. I've been looking at a bunch of info about it again, and I'm like, frick, I really want to play this game. This all ties back, it's a long circle back to what I've been playing this week. So, I put on the 10-day trial, and I was like, let's see if they optimized it anymore. Answer, they did not, at least for AMD processors. So, but I still played it, I told Eric earlier before we started, I still played for like 45 minutes. So I'm like, this is just fun. I want to play, but I can't because it's bad FPS and I can't, and I'll lose my mind. But, so I played that for a little bit and found out that I couldn't really, play it yet.
Yeah.
Because, not really segue because I'm not done with what I've been playing. Yeah. And I don't want to discuss news, but we'll discuss why. We'll bring that back into the equation later.
Set the segue off to the left.
And, yeah, it's right over here.
Bring it back.
I'll grab it later. Pull it back in. So, I think that actually is all I've been playing.
Yeah.
First. So, yeah, you know. Try to Ether 1. Okay, yeah. You know what? Yeah, let's talk about it. Let's get it out of the way. I'm pulling it back. I'm pulling it back real quick. It only sat over there for
beep,
a second.
Beep, beep, back it only, up.
Backing up. The topic only sat over here to the left for like a second. Pulling the segue back in. Here it is. All right. So I ordered myself a new computer, basically. Yeah. That's the only, like, I don't want to spend too much time on this, but like people who follow me, Grunt specifically, Reckless might know this. I wanted to stream PC games, but I freaking couldn't because my computer's processor is awful. Yeah. So I would try and then keep trying and it didn't work.
Right.
But with this, oh my gosh, Eric, this is my goal. I got such a good computer because I got it on a sale. And basically the reason I was able to afford this was because graduation money and I got a paycheck recently and one other thing. Oh, tax returns. So like all of that and the sale just added up. So basically I got like a $2,000 computer for like $1,500.
Amazing.
And then so.
Top of line, mate.
Yeah, rattling off the specs super quick. 2 terabyte hard drive, which doesn't really matter that much. i7-4790K, 4 gigahertz processor. GTX 760 and 16 gigabytes of RAM and Windows 8.1, but who freaking cares about that? So really good. If I can't run WildStar at I'm not even gonna say Ultra. If I can't run WildStar at 60 frames, I'm gonna freaking lose my mind.
Yeah,
you're good. Should be able to. But that's the main reason. I just want to play WildStar, so I'm excited to be able to do that. And maybe if it's good enough. It might even be good enough to stream at 60 FPS.
That, or you could just use it to stream games on your other computer.
Yeah, so that's
the computer you're on now. I mean,
yeah, that was my goal. I'm not gonna get rid of this computer yet. And if I do ever get rid of it, I'm gonna sell it because I don't want to like. Oh, let me just toss out this $500 computer. No, I'm not gonna do that. But so yeah, I just wanted to cover that quickly. So maybe you'll be seeing more PC stuff from me in the future. That's should awesome. Be shipping.
There's on... like one thing before we move on. If there's any game that I would probably get on PC rather than PS4 or any other place, it probably would be Fallout because of all the modifications you can do to Bethesda's games. It's pretty.
About that modern life, bro. Ain't about that. But. All about that trophy life, you know what I'm saying? But speaking of no, I'm not going to do that. I want to save the best piece of news. That's right. The best for last.
No, the best.
Nah, we'll save Fallout for last. Because it's the best for most people. But we'll talk about the second best. Second to last. The best for me. But let's start off the news.
Holy crap. I just read that first one.
Yeah, it's rough. So let's just get the depressing crap out of the way. Out the window.
That's something. Yeah. Out the window.
Window! So
this window, right there.
Eric just picked up his camera and moved it over to the window. No, I'm not going to do it. It's too dark. You can't even tell. Just throw the webcam over to the window. So Constantine...
Constantine.
Yeah, this article... is titled Constantine TV series officially dead.
Just wow, that's
so, yeah.
Cool.
People were the producers and whatnot, people were trying to find They were trying to find a different network to put it on, some way to save the show, and now they're like, nope, couldn't find anyone. It's over.
Dang, dude.
Quick piece of news.
Though, Del Toro apparently says he's open to using Matt Ryan as Constantine in the Justice League Dark film.
Awesome. Matt Ryan's a cool dude.
Ryan, he's a great actor. It's just, I got very freaking uninterested.
I could not.
Halfway through the season.
I couldn't find a way to care about what was going on each episode. That was...
I thought I would like it because it reminded me of, like, Supernatural and stuff. But, no, it's just halfway through, I was like...
Yeah, I don't know why. So, Eric, are you ready to clear up even more space on your hard drive if you get this game, which you might not even, because the Arkham Knight is another big game.
Yeah.
It's very big.
This is why I get physical.
Yeah, but nowadays, physical are almost as much as freaking digital because of updates. So, Batman Arkham Knight is, actually, it's not as, well, no, this is still pretty big. It's 45 gigs.
Yeah, that's about the same size as Outlook 4.
Elder Scrolls Online, which is coming up this Tuesday.
One day, exactly, almost.
Yeah, Elder Scrolls Online is freaking, like, huge.
One day and 1 hour for me.
I think it's the biggest game file size.
Well, it when I downloaded it, when I preloaded it, it said that it was only, like, 30-something.
Mine's 55. Check it. Go to information and check
I did. That's site. Why I know that it's 35. So
When you downloaded it, it downloaded 35. That's the part where you can actually start the game, remember? And then when it's quote unquote downloaded, it downloads more. Remember? That's how preloading works.
No. I've never preloaded a game before.
Oh, well.
PS4. I've never pre-ordered a game digitally on PS4. So this is the first time having a ticker counting down on my PS4, so
it's pretty cool. But yeah, like go to options and information, and it'll say size 55 gigs.
I did that. Hold on. See, it says information 55. Okay, what the heck? Okay,
I told you.
It literally said 30 something.
I know. That's weird. Did you do the information when it was downloading? Because if you do that, it'll show. The first one.
Like, yeah, I preloaded it, like, way earlier the other day when I first bought it.
Yeah.
And,
it was probably still downloading. That would take
It's possible. But yeah, 55.22. Completed. It said completed earlier, but...
Actually, to be honest... Oh, no. Oh, well. I don't know. I thought I heard there might be a day one patch.
Possibly. I don't doubt it.
I don't know. I will be playing that game Tuesday night. Are you working on Tuesday? I will be streaming that game Tuesday night
on PS4. I am.
I'm working Tuesday.
I am working.
That's why I asked. Are you working till like 8?
I hope not. I don't think so.
I'm working like 12 to or two. Early to like.
I don't work 3. Tomorrow. I wish I could move my day shift to tomorrow. I wouldn't mind working.
Dude, I immediately, when I saw Tuesday, I was like, can someone trade with me? Can we switch shifts, please, someone? And nobody wanted to.
Rip.
Rip. Oh. But when I get back from work on Tuesday, I will immediately be doing
it. Hohokam is like 3 gigs.
Big at all? That's about what
Inside
I would
Inside 2
say.
Is 12 gigs.
Oh, dang.
Yeah.
That's about what I would These are mostly what I would expect. I wouldn't I was going to say I wouldn't expect Elder Scrolls Online to be that big, but it's an MMO.
Yeah.
It's a lot of environment.
Right.
So, yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Arkham Knight is coming out in 2 weeks, basically. 2 weeks from this upcoming.
Yep.
Tuesday. Yeah, 2 weeks from this upcoming Tuesday, which is. The day before you are listening to this, if you are listening to it on Monday when it comes out, or when it should come out. Last week, let's segue real quick.
Last week,
it's not really a segue if you call
like,
it out. Like
I bet like 50 episodes down the road of our podcast, we're finally going to get like a graphic that just has a segue going across the screen or something.
Just like Star Wars transition to the same thing.
Yes. Did you remember the ESO... live stream when they did their transitions?
Yeah,
it's just like
basically
those were odd. And then
those are odd to me.
Back to the same camera view, but okay.
That was odd to me because like
it was odd. I was like,
it was okay. The same one, and the transition lasted way too long.
Right.
And then, I don't know, but you lost my segue, Eric. Good
Sorry.
Job.
Segue is missing.
It's gone.
It's broken.
It's gone. out the window. Seriously, what? I give up anyway. Yeah, I will be streaming. So
file size streaming ESO.
Yeah, I'll be streaming it on PS4 on Tuesday night or maybe Tuesday with afternoon. Me. Yeah, even if Eric's not there, I'm gonna like start one character and then yeah, it's gonna be good. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be real good. I'm so like me and Eric were talking about how like. Yeah, he bought it, and then he told me today, he was like, man, I really want to play ESO. And I'm like, I know, right?
I played it yesterday, and I was like,
yeah, that's one of the things I played last week. I knew I was forgetting something. Yeah. I played Elder Scrolls Online for like 45 minutes just because I was like, I want this out
I
right
did
now.
Level 10, so I did played the level 10, what was it, the level 10 story mission?
Yeah.
And it was pretty cool because you... go fight big stuff.
There's like action. There, like I jumped in for like 45 minutes, and it made me so happy because I'm like, there's actually like a story, and like everything, like I'm invested in all.
It's
of
like
this,
every so five good. Levels, there's a new story mission to do.
So
it's like
good. Really cool. So I am very excited for that game. We're covering all of this before even the drop, but I don't give one flying fart. So
yeah.
All right. Phil Spencer has officially crushed the rumor. Phil Spencer, head of Xbox, by the way, has officially crushed the rumor that Microsoft is going to be helping revive the Silent Hills game that was canceled.
You know, as much as I'd like to think that he's telling the truth, I don't for some reason.
What?
I don't know.
What?
Microsoft.
He officially said.
Yes, he officially said.
Sorry, this isn't true. Not sure where the rumor started, but I don't want to mislead anyone.
Yeah.
So you're gonna be like, you're gonna say he's gonna come out at E3
bam,
and be like,
hey guys,
psych!
We're actually doing it. I nope, can see him doing that and be like, you guys did it last E3 at Sony. Now we can do it too. And just like pull a freaking. I don't know. I think it would be funny, but
Sony didn't do that.
No, they did. Yeah, they did the freaking. Hey, this is how you share games on PS4.
Okay, that wasn't changing their mind on anything.
Oh no, it was a burn. I'm talking about burns here.
Oh,
not...
well, that wouldn't burn PlayStation really. That's just an exclusive.
That's yes.
That's not like.
But that thing.
We've got a share button now too. Suck it. Oh. It's an external share button. It's like a Staples button on your desk that you're just like, boom. Nah.
We have a GG button.
Gabby got one of those. It's so dumb, dude. I wanted to be like nice button. I wanted to be like
GG.
I wanted to be like that's pretty funny or nice button, but I'm like. So dumb, because the way the guy says it is like, yeah. What is he even saying? Anyways. Yeah. Two PS4 models are rumored to be coming out, as in two new PS4 models.
Maybe they... Microsoft will buy them.
What? But one is with a terabyte hard drive, which is good. I think it's crazy.
Slim.
Yeah, I really hope that Microsoft and Sony come out with like new models at E3 just to be like, here's a terabyte hard drive model, because 500 gigs is not enough. Is not enough at all. I have a 2 terabyte hard drive in my PS4, so GG.
Yeah.
But yeah, I hope they do that. I hope both of them do this. I hope this leak is true, because I hope a terabyte. PS4
it's
needs
believable.
To be on the market.
Yeah,
it should be
definitely, especially with games being like 50 gigabytes nowadays.
Yep, even the physical ones. Like,
yep,
ESO dude. Is still 50 gigs if you get it physically.
When I was going through my storage, Last of Us is like 50 gigs.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I have physical too, so
yep. Yeah, that's insane. That is insane. Do I have the Last of Us physical?
I hope so, because that's like one game of all the games that I would probably get physical if I was a digital buyer.
Digital's the future, mate. It's the future.
But this case, this box art is really beautiful.
Yeah, you could say that about every box art.
Yeah,
well, not really every
box art.
Yeah, but...
Even though this game sucked, it had pretty good.
Even though this game sucked. Calling it like it is.
Yeah.
So, Eric... Let's talk about what's really important.
Uncharted?
Uncharted 4! Store! Box art! You thought I was gonna say collection, didn't you? Psych! That's the wrong number. All right, here.
Well, I mean, this is a familiar picture.
Yeah, I'm just showing
obviously,
it to you.
But it is the box art.
Yeah, it is the official box art, but it's basically, if you've seen any promotional images for our Uncharted 4 so far, like, that's the box art.
Yeah.
You do see, like, the trees are kind of like, that. Like, that's not really, they kind of just showed him in the promotional images. This is like, actually, yeah. There's like trees outlining and the leaves.
It is very dark, though. It's really kind of sad.
So
like,
scared.
Like, he looks so beat up.
So
and
scared but, about I mean, that game.
I'm not. They, I have full, there's still going to be the peppy, we're still going to have the peppy humor and all that.
Yeah.
But.
The only,
I feel like something is going to happen.
The only way that I would feel like they would still have that humor is because of an interview where they're like, yeah, it's still going to be a lighthearted, like, action flick type thing. If I hadn't seen that interview, I'm like, what the frick? This is a new tone. This is a completely new direction for the series. If I hadn't seen that interview, I would completely think that because all the trailers and whatnot so far have been like that.
Yeah.
But Eric, I got you on that last one, but this one.
Yep.
This one's for real, right?
And I'm gonna buy this one.
Let's talk about a little ditty.
Which called, we called.
called Uncharted, the Nathan Drake Collection.
Teddy, you.
And it's coming out on October 9th, 2015. Whoa!
Dude, like we called it. We're like.
Everyone
okay, okay, they're pushing Uncharted 4 back really far for some reason. Because wasn't it supposed to come out at the beginning of this year or something?
Let's come out 2015.
Yeah, but, I mean, so they're pushing it like 2016, which means, okay, they gotta give us something. What are they doing? They're freaking Uncharted collection.
So,
yeah.
I'm trying to figure out if we should, for our E3 predictions, if we should count what they are as a, you know, like, if we should really, what are you doing?
It's not focusing.
I can't see
but
it.
But it's my pre-order for Uncharted 4.
Oh, snap. So, is it like $5 pre-ordered or like?
No, it's full thing. I've had
it.
Oh,
baby.
I've had this since they first announced it.
A triple. I've been, when they first announced it, I was immediately like, I want to pre-order this so badly, but I won't because I want to pre-order the collector's edition when they announce it.
Yeah.
So I'm waiting for that. But, you know, it'll be a ways away, which is fine. But Uncharted Nathan Drake Collection. Okay, story of what happened here. Basically, PlayStation
Master's
Store.
Master's Thief Collection.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, gosh. PlayStation Store on this here mobile. Like, basically on, I think it was either Monday or Tuesday night or something.
Yeah.
There was just a, like, the actual
just
image.
Picture just, of the box art.
Just hanging out in the store. And Greg tweeted out and was like, hey, PlayStation, you might want to remove
yeah,
this.
Yeah, and then Neil Druckmann was like, oops. Well, see you guys in the morning. And then we did the morning, like, yep, it's true.
So they announced it in the morning. And, I was like, oh my gosh. And I just looked at that tweet like a bunch and I was like,
yeah.
Oh, please be true. And then I was like going to sleep and I was on my phone and I scrolled over to find the image and I'm just like, it's there. I can see it myself. Oh my gosh. Here
you
it
know,
is.
Kind of funny. He hasn't really talked about it much. They haven't made a video on it.
I'm very
shocked. Oh my gosh.
I'm very shocked they did not do a kind of funny reaction.
Reacts, yeah.
Anyways. So I went and I looked it up on my own phone because I was so excited. And then the next morning when I saw the actual legit trailer and all that, I immediately was like, oh, PS4, turn on, go to the store. Can I pre-order it? Can I? No,
wait, there's
no,
a,
it's
there's
not
a,
there.
And
then,
a trailer?
Yeah, it's just Sully talking, though.
No oh, yeah, that thing. Okay.
Yeah. But then I went, so I went on immediately that morning. I'm like, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? And then I couldn't find it.
Watch it be
and
there then, now.
No, it is there. This is the point, Eric. Let me finish my story! Story!
They pre-ordered it now, though.
Let me finish! Oh, you're looking at... That was a chipmunk face. That was like an evil chipmunk. But...
Skeleton.
Yeah, so I went... I went that morning and I was like, it's not there. And then later that night, Shuhei tweeted something about like, I pre-ordered Uncharted 4 and got this new dynamic theme for the, oh my gosh, what are you doing?
I'm dead, mate.
That was horrifying. I was literally like in my own world and then I look up at the computer. My goodness. So yeah, Shuhei tweeted that out. Shuhei at USP on Twitter, follow him. He's cool. He's a cool dude. So I went, I saw that and I was like, oh, it's there! It's there! Turn on PS4 and I'm like, come on, go to the store. I was like, yes, yes, pre-order, yep, add to cart, add funds, yep, done. And then you know how, you know, games have like the timer.
Yeah.
And it's like 126 days. Like,
RIP.
Dang it. But I immediately put on the theme. The theme is so good for all you Uncharted fans out there, because the theme has the menu sounds and the, oh, it's great. It's great. Little, this guy over here is very excited, if you know what I'm saying. Nathan Drake statue, what up? Sorry.
You know, as much, you remember when I said that I wasn't going to like pre-order anything? That's for certain games. Like, The Order, it's a new IP. We didn't know what we were getting, so you don't pre-order it. So, but
some games Uncharted 4, know what you're
we know what we're getting into here. Speaking of the Uncharted Collection, obviously, what we're getting into here.
That game is gonna be FPS. So awesome. Let me read some from this article here. Let me open it up because IGN talked to some of the developers. Let's see here. October 9th, by the way, just tossing that out there. It's Uncharted 1, 2, and 3. No Golden Abyss, which is not too shocking, but, you know, it would have been cool. Let's see here. Remastered by Bluepoint Games. Expect new... Wow! Wow!
What?
Luke Carmali calling you out right now, IGN editor. What are you doing? He wrote, remastered by Bluepoint Games, expect new achievements along with 1080p graphics at 60fps. He wrote on a PlayStation exclusive brand, one of the highest selling PlayStation exclusive brands, expect new achievements.
At first I was like, well, okay, achievements. So trophies are achievements, I guess. But
it's true. But so this is the best. Other than that one thing, I'll read this paragraph and correct it as I go. It says remastered by Bluepoint Games. Expect new trophies along with 1080p graphics at 60fps and better lighting, textures, and models. Gameplay improvements are also on the way with an announcement on that front coming soon. As in probably an Uncharted 1, they don't make you do the dumb grenade thing where you have to use the six axis on the controller. So. This is a remastered. This is not a port. These are not ports.
Yeah, like, you said they were, like, fixing controls for some of the games or whatever?
It says gameplay improvements are also on the way with an announcement on that front.
Good, because, I mean, like, I've heard, like, the earlier games where, like, the first two or whatever had, like, some weird controls for some...
I didn't mind any of them. I mean, I haven't played one, but one apparently literally had where, like, oh, throw the grenade by moving the controller and, like this, if people watching...
Yeah, if they can just keep it, like, Uncharted 3, then, like...
Oh, wow. It continues to go on to say, anyone who pre-orders this game will get the Nathan Drake pack, which includes single-player skins, the golden AK-47, and golden 92 FS guns. If you pre-order the digital download via the PlayStation Store, you will also get the Uncharted Nathan Drake Collection PS4 Dynamic Theme, which is what I got.
And you will get access to the Uncharted 4 multiplayer beta.
Yup! I am so stoked right now, I can't even deal with it. I am way more stoked about this than I am the next thing that we're going to talk about, but everyone else is the opposite, so let's move on to that. It's okay. But freaking, you better bet your little butt that on October 9th, I'm going to be streaming this for, like, the rest of my life.
All right. Next thing.
So, you may have heard of a little game called Fallout 3.
Yeah. What was it? What day was it that this they went live.
I don't know.
It was it was earlier in the week. Bethesda's Twitch stream went up, and it had some similarities of the Fallout-esque loading screens and such. And people were like, okay, yeah, that's pretty much Fallout 4 confirmed. And what do you know, next day when they when that timer went down, Fallout 4 trailer plays.
Yeah, it said...
The internet explode, trending everywhere.
Yeah, it said, and, please stand by.
Yep.
And then it actually... So, let's watch this trailer, because as I was telling Eric earlier, I haven't even seen the trailer yet. So, let's watch it. I can give you... Oh, no, the link's already in the
doc. Yeah, I'm already...
Never mind. 3, 2, 1, play.
Peggy 18.
Peggy
18. Yeah, pretty much. It shows this is going to be set in Boston.
Yeah. I bought Fallout 3, by the way, for people.
Yeah. Which is set in...
I went to buy it on PS3. You can't buy it digitally. It literally says only on disc when you go to the store page. Yeah,
it's weird. It's a really old game, and it's a very glitchy too.
It's so weird.
With the world poised on the brink of war, Vault-Tec is reporting a record number.
Call it a ghost.
Riley.
We got some breaking news. Stand by.
The cool thing about Fallout is that it's set in the future, but everything is styled like it's in like the 60s or something. It's very interesting. There's like lasers and robots and stuff.
With our affiliate stations. Stand by. We do have coming in confirmed reports of nuclear detonation. My God. Our soldiers were right.
Dang, son. What a good trailer.
War never changes.
War never changes. Every dang trailer for the Fallout series. This guy.
Says well, that. It doesn't.
Never changes.
Look at Riley. Roaming around.
See the building from The Last of Us right there?
Yeah.
And this is my, this right here is my, desktop screen. Actually, it's panned off to a little right, but, yeah.
Let's go, pal.
That is such an awesome trailer.
It's just...
That's a really good trailer.
The best thing about it is, like, I mean, it... For someone who hasn't, like, played a Fallout game, there doesn't say much in that trailer, but for someone who knows, like, some of the backstory and the first and Fallout 3, it just says so much right there what's going to be going on. It's crazy.
It's still a good trailer, though, good trailer. For people who haven't played Fallout. That's what I'm saying. Dang, son, that's awesome. I love people. There's two things that's weird about me but that are true. When it comes to video games, I love pet systems and fishing in games. So yeah. I very much the dog thing is awesome.
The dog thing is really putting off. Like, do you get a pet to, like, you know, have around? Does
oh, you're totally
also,
gonna get the dog.
People are also at least Cullen Moriarty here, probably along Rhode, Rhode Island.
Rhode Island. Did you just say Pride of Rhode Island?
Yes, Rhode Island. Switching up here.
Wow. Wrecked. Get wrecked, Colin. All your heritage and all that you care about, Eric, is wrecked.
Part of something.
Long Island.
Long Island, yes.
My computer's being loud. Okay.
Yeah. He said that the guy there at the end of the trailer, he was actually talking, usually in Fallout games.
Yeah, I heard about
it. Character doesn't talk. So maybe our character is going to be more involved.
Yeah. Hopefully.
That would be really cool because, I mean, I like the silent protagonist sometimes, but sometimes I really like, in a game like Fallout at least, it would be cool to have some inputs from our
protagonist. I don't know if I have ever really liked silent protagonists. It doesn't make any sense to me.
The weirdest protagonist, I think, that I've come across is probably Master Chief, though.
The weirdest for me is Link in Skyward Sword.
Yeah.
So freaking weird, because everyone else is talking, but he's saying nothing. Nothing at all.
And they kind of guess what you're thinking or something.
Yeah. It's like everyone is just hearing stuff that I'm not hearing. I don't know. But...
Right.
Yeah, apparently Master Chief gets, like, more talkative as the games go on.
Yeah, it's true.
He started off...
The first game, he just says, like, some orders and, like, some, like, what's this? What's going on? But then he gets a little bit more talkative. Halo 4, he actually starts saying what he thinks because he's been, like, freaking brainwashed into being a Spartan.
So. Man, I want to play all the Halo games so bad. Put those on PC, yo. Put those on PC, Microsoft. Make a ton of money. You know, that's actually true. Just put the Master Chief collection on PC.
Just get a ton of money.
And me and Eric would buy it. So there's $120 right there. So.
Yeah.
yeah, dude. Fallout 4. It's actually happening. What I said, and Eric was like, you know, I don't fully... Eric didn't fully get it. But what I said is, I don't fully... And the guys over at Rooster Teeth, Gus Cirola, Bernie Burns, and Ashley Jenkins all agree with me that...
Yeah.
It's very odd that they announced this game. Like, they set up this whole press conference. It's their first time doing a press conference at E3, Bethesda's first time.
Yes.
And they, like, set it all up, and they weren't saying anything.
And they didn't announce it, yeah.
And then they just announced it before E3.
Yeah. I'm gonna speak directly from the... I'm going to take words right out of Colin Moriarty's mouth and say it's because it would have been leaked before. And if it was leaked, it wouldn't have been as grand.
Why would it have been leaked? But see,
because when it gets closer to E3...
Also, this is what Gus said to that. He said they weren't... it wasn't... Well, actually, Gus is kind of dumb when it comes to this now that I'm thinking about what he said. Because he said they weren't in danger of being leaked because they had a timer. Like, they planned this. It wasn't like, oh, no, somebody's going to leak this. Get it out now. They, like, planned it out.
So. Yeah. They wanted full control of this. And if someone were to, like, maybe see some footage, like, behind the scenes at E3, or maybe someone at Bethesda themselves was like, oh, I'm going to, like, leak it right before E3, or something like that, the guys who wanted to show it, they showed it at the time they wanted to, and no one else did.
Yeah.
So that's, I agree with Colin in this because they got the reaction they wanted, even though it wasn't an E3.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. But, odd. It's very odd that the Uncharted Collection and Fallout 4 are huge pieces of news.
Yeah.
And those both came out before E3. It's odd. I don't know. It's just odd. Those are E3 also, worthy, you know.
Here's another
thing.
Those
are press conference types of things.
Here's another thing, dude. We're going to see gameplay of Fallout 4.
Yeah, that's...
Here's the thing. That's and also, true. People are going to come to E3 just to see Fallout.
So, you said that earlier, and I'm like, Eric, there was no concern for E3 attendance. E3
no,
is all press.
But, yes, yes.
So, they're going to go anyways because they're press. And they were going to go because they thought Fallout 4 was going to be announced.
Right.
And that's even...
It's not being announced. It's going to get gameplay.
Yeah, I don't know.
So, yeah.
It'll definitely get gameplay. And my thing is, are they going to do anything to show off the Uncharted Collection? I don't think they will.
Because,
if they show off a level... It's kind of like we've already seen that level before.
Well, we know what we're getting. So, I mean...
Yeah, that's the point. Are they gonna... I don't feel like there's gonna... Maybe there'll be another trailer. Yeah, maybe there will be a trailer of, like, gameplay footage.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, clips from all three different games, and then blah, 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 October 9th.
Right.
That's my guess of what they're gonna show for that.
Yeah.
But they're not gonna do, like, a demo, because it's like, we've already seen all three of the
games. Oh, yeah, you guys can... we can fly across these buildings, and you can...
Dude.
You know, the spiders.
I want that so badly. Like, holy crap. I want that Uncharted 3 Platinum that my PlayStation 3
you know what Greg
cheated
said,
out of me.
Greg tweeted saying, allow us to play Crushing on our first playthrough.
Yes! They better.
That would be great, just to get the Platinum.
They better. Yeah, you probably shouldn't do that, though, just for reference. And I probably wouldn't do that on 2 or 1. I'd only do that on 3.
Well, I don't know. I'll probably play the lowest, or the not the lowest. The one before Crushing.
Well, that's hard, and that's still pretty hard. Hard is still pretty. Crushing is ridiculous. I've played Uncharted 3 like 4 times, and that's why I did Crushing. Like, or that's why I did well in Crushing, because I like knew the levels and knew where people were coming. If I was going through that game on the first time on hard or Crushing, like, I just get freaking wrecked because they come from areas I don't know. I did well on Crushing because I was like, okay, I'm going in this level, they're coming from here, I'm gonna get in this cover and get this gun, that's gonna be good.
But
I don't know, I would suggest normal, but you could handle hard. Apparently, Uncharted 2 specifically is really difficult. Like, Crushing on 2 is apparently, like, way worse than
Crushing
3 or 1. So, yes.
It is.
Some
crushing.
Might say it is crushing. That trophy that
crushes
didn't
your
pop
soul.
Was crushing to my soul.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
That was the worst. So, yeah. Lots of stuff, dude. There's not much that we can talk about in Destiny because Eric didn't play too much, and
no, we can
I didn't get
say
anything.
That we thoroughly rectified those people in
the anus, in the anus.
Yes,
specifically the anus.
Yeah, in Trials, man, that was good. That was good.
Oh, you guys should. I uploaded we weren't streaming that night because Twitch was super broken, but I had my favorite Striker super since launch. So I just pressed
good.
The share
I
button,
watched it.
Trimmed it, and uploaded it.
I was
so
like, okay, that's... Wow.
It's in the YouTube channel. Now you understand why I was freaking out. Because, as I told Ryan, I was at the peak of my jetpack when I pressed it. So I went even higher. So I was at the peak already. Went even higher with Fist of Havoc because it shoots you up a little bit. And then I landed on a slope that's lower. So I started from the high ground, went as high as possible, and landed lower. So it was like I was flying through the air. That's why it was awesome.
Yeah, it was a pretty good and it ended the match too.
Which was like perfect. Good. And what was even better about it, but that the share button didn't pick up, was that Ryan was like, oh guys, self-res, be careful. And I was like, hey guys, watch this. And then it happened. And it was done. The round was over. It was beautiful.
I was trying to kill them, and I think they killed Ryan, and I was going up to kill them, and then I saw you coming from the sky.
Yeah, Ryan,
bam.
You guys both said that you just saw me in
You were just
air.
Like, oh, okay.
and then it was over. So that was like, that like rejuvenated my love for the Striker Super. Like, when I played that in beta, you know, I was like, frick, man, I'm gonna be Superman, jumping all over the place, it's gonna be great. And then, you know, after you play a while, it's not... You don't feel the Superman, like...
Right.
Feel super powerful type thing.
You weren't even using Death from Above.
No, that's why it was freaking great. Oh, man, that was great. Anyways. Dude. You know, about to end the podcast, but I also played Metal Gear Solid Ground Zeroes.
Yeah, so did I.
But
oh
I played...
my gosh, I totally forgot that.
But I played that today. So...
Yeah. I want to play them... I should... After this, I might...
Dude, that game is so good. It's a lot of fun.
I really would like to see a collection. I'm going to be honest. I read into something. I watched some gameplay of
a Metal Gear collection?
Game. Yes.
There is. It's on PS3. And Vita.
Okay.
So, sorry, mate. I don't know if they're going to do
it
again.
I might just get a PS3.
You really
I don't
should.
Know.
I always feel like people who don't own a PS3 or Vita and own PS Plus are, like, literally... I feel like they're losing money each month with all of the free games. Because,
yeah.
Like, there's so many good ones.
Like,
I really want to start Mass Effect. Holy crap, I want to...
Yeah, MGS is really cool, actually. I never really got into it, but it's...
Yeah.
It's really cool. Tactical espionage... something. But yeah.
The stealth is, like, I don't know. The
stealth is pretty good. Good stealth.
Same. So. Like, I don't know. I like, it's a lot more difficult.
And thinking. There's a lot of thinking.
It's very, it's more difficult than an average modern game nowadays.
Yeah.
That's for sure. Like, there, I got to this one point where it was like, here's this tape. Listen to it. Listen to the audio clues.
Yeah, I thought that was awesome.
Go through the environment and find where it was.
Yeah, it's like
where
flag,
I was like,
gate, and blah.
Yeah,
and
but
you get to go and search
see,
for it.
See, now I'm in this point where it's like, I know where it is, but I gotta get there. And
yeah.
There's a lot of guards. A lot
there
of
is.
Guards. So I'm just like taking my time. But see, that's why I asked you earlier if there was a if they respawned, because like if there was a limited number, I could just slowly pick off
right.
one by one.
That's what I
win.
Thought. Like I thought at first, but what I found out is that
that's what I'm trying to do.
To have a game plan and do it fast, because you'll get someone might see you. If someone sees you, try to take him out quick, and it's.
Well, I've been playing the game super slow.
So yeah, you need to play it slow when you're trying to move around and situate yourself. But when you're acting on when you're going out to like take someone out or something, you need to do it like with speed of light, like Sonic,
like
or
Flash, yeah.
Flash,
Barry Allen,
Rip Flash. It's not gonna be back for
Rip ever. The Flash. He's
actually
dead.
Seriously Rip Flash. That his world is going to die if he doesn't actually fix
yeah.
That. Wormhole
yeah,
thing.
Rip Barry Allen, frick. I'm so season 2 is gonna be crazy.
What if season 2 we just like see freaking the other another different Flash walking down the road
Dude,
and it's a whole new show.
Not that. It's not gonna be like here's Wally West and we're starting over.
Yeah, Wally West. Like here's a new.
Nah, they're not gonna do that. But Wally West is going to be in season 2. Just letting you.
But I just thought it'd be funny if like. They show the beginning of season 2. They just show Barry going, and then he fails. And then the next scene
and then
is
it
just
restarts.
It just goes to Wally just walking down the street.
And it's like, but it starts in like the parallel universe, but like Superman's there, and Cyborg's there.
Yep.
Oh, man.
Yep.
But,
that would be hilarious, but also bad because
yeah,
I love
be
Barry.
Awful.
Barry's awesome.
Be funny. But. I think that's going to cover it for this week. Let's go over the drop. I already have it open, but let's go over that, and then we'll do our plugs and get out of here. And I have my random. I have the random object of the week. I am so ready.
Do you know?
Oh. I'm pretty sure anyone here could guess what it is.
Okay, that's why I have a random object too, so we got this, mate.
People who have never seen this podcast or don't know the origin of the random object are probably so confused.
Yeah.
Basically what happened is that on the first episode, Eric, when we were ending, he was like, I was like, you got anything else to say before we end? And he was like, potatoes, they're cool. Something like that. It was something like that.
Yeah,
know.
I'm about to go back to it and see what.
And
I
then I was like, I was like, man, we should do that. We should end every podcast with a random object, and we've been doing that ever since. We'll just pull something out of our rooms and show. It's show and tell. That's what.
Yeah,
it is.
Show
and
tell.
That's
pretty much
show
it.
And tell. So, Eric, let's go over these games that are coming out this week, but let's talk about. The best, the Mona Lisa of this list, some might say. Let's talk about that one last. So let's just go through and then do that one. So I will cover the first one. Let's switch, let's go back and forth. So Arcade Archives Gradius for the PS4, which I feel like every week the drop starts out with an Arcade Archives game.
Hey, I mean, look, it's by Konami.
Oh, snap. So, yeah. Arcade Archives. If you were one of the... If you're super old and you played that game in an arcade, that's for you.
Yep. All right. Next, we have Hustle Kings.
Oh, man. We're going to be hustling everybody.
And it's, it looks like it's a billiards and poker game.
It's a... Yep.
Yep.
Have fun with that, everybody. Sounds it looks like there's compete against the world in one-on-one matches and multiplayer tournaments to rise up the online league.
Wonder if it's better than Destiny's Connection.
Oh, no. Invoker's Tournament for a PS4. Wow, this is a MOBA. This looks awful. Just from that one picture. Do you see that picture? That looks awful. Fight your way through frenetic online.
She doesn't have a nose.
Nose? Battles in this new action MOBA. So yeah, if you're looking for a MOBA on the PS4 that most likely is awful, there you go.
She doesn't have a nose. She looks kind of looks like Wonder Woman, a bad woman to Wonder Woman.
Yeah. You never know. Maybe it's the next League of Legends.
Yeah.
Maybe it's gonna take over Twitch. Not me.
All right. Next, we got Lego Jurassic World. That movie's not even out yet. What the heck?
I know! That was my first reaction. I'm like, this movie's
spoilers.
Not out. Yeah. So, if you want to, maybe there's like hints about the upcoming game. I don't fully know how that, or upcoming movie.
Jurassic World video game for Lego.
I don't fully know how this works, but there you go. PS4, PS3, and Vita. Don't buy Lego games on your Vita, by the way, thinking it's going to be like the console port, because it's not. They do the 3DS port for the Vita, which is a bummer because they could easily do the console one. Oh well. Operation Abyss, New Tokyo Legacy. One of them silly JRPG Vita games with the girls.
Yeah.
One of those comes every week.
Yeah, that's true. Anyway. Demos and betas, Tropical 5.
So, let's wrap up, and let's say that Ryan Clements, PlayStation Powerhouse, brings us this last one as well, because I forgot to mention that at the beginning. Eric, regale us as to what is coming out this week.
Okay. Friends over at ZeniMax, or Zoss.
Zoss.
That's what they said in the stream, at least.
Yeah.
Awesome. Anyway, ZeniMax and Bethesda bringing us Elder Scrolls Online to the PS4. Not a port, a complete, pretty much a remaster in terms of HUD and UI and gameplay.
VoIP is a thing.
VoIP.
Tamriel Unlimited, which means no subscription price.
Yep.
And, like, fishing.
On PS4.
On PS4. Elder Scrolls MMO, no subscription, on PS4.
A quality
designed
MMO.
Designed for
on
the PS4.
The PS4. On, I mean...
If you liked Skyrim, if you liked any of the Elder Scrolls games, and if you don't mind playing with other people, so heck, maybe you like playing with other people. Most people do. Then play this game, because it's really awesome.
Yeah.
I will
Side
be streaming...
Side quests are, like, extremely meaningful, and there's, like, it's kind of like The Witcher. You know, you go up to
some lady,
and she's like,
it's multiplayer Witcher.
Can you do this for me? Kill these ghouls for me?
But see...
And it's great.
Yeah, but see, it's not even like that, because if it was like that, then it'd be World of Warcraft, where it's just like, hey, yo, go get those 5 wolf skins for me, bro.
Right.
It's actually, like each side quest
can you
has
stop
a...
this? Can you stop this evil witch ritual on this boat that has a giant freaking storm around it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How about you go arrest this guy who's selling skooma in these parts? You know, like it's not all like just go kill 10 of whatever. It's really good. So I am going to.
Or go into oblivion and find a Daedric prince.
Oh, is that a thing? Well,
yeah, I did that.
That's a freaking thing?
I went into Oblivion, and I found a Daedric Prince, and I talked to him.
GG. That's awesome. So, I am going to be streaming that on Tuesday night. Eric will be there. We will be playing the crap out of this. Twitch.tv/TBESTIACGames. TBESTIAC. And with that, let's go to our plugs. You can reach out to us on Twitter. I am at TVCAC, like I just spelled and out. Eric is now at Legend PVM.
Yes.
He used to be at Eric Bailey 15 and was all confusing and whatnot. But he stepped up in the world of social media.
Yep.
So, there you go. So, reach out to us on Twitter. YouTube.com/TBCAC. I am starting to upload more. I will. But, oh, we didn't even explain why our podcast was out so late this past week.
Oh, yeah.
Last week, it was supposed to be out on Tuesday because we recorded on Monday. But then my computer, I tried it three just nights in a row. Yeah. Every time I tried to render, I would wake up and the computer had shut itself off without rendering it. So I just sent it to Eric and he did it. So I'm going to send it to you again, Eric, after this.
Oh, great.
Yeah, have fun. You can just do it when you go to sleep, too. That's, I mean, just set it to render and then you don't have to worry about it. But, yeah, that's
my
why it
computer,
came out so late.
I don't want my computer to die.
It won't. I mean, you have a better computer than me. I don't assume. If it handled it last time, it should be fine. Because it's just the same thing. Maybe even less time on the podcast. So that is it. What is your random item to show off to us today?
So when I got my job, I was issued a pen and a box cutter. So,
oh, snap!
Yeah, I'm showing my box cutter.
The big plays. That's awesome.
Yep.
That's a good random item.
On Tuesdays and Fridays, we have freight that comes in to restock shelves, obviously. Yeah. And there's lots of boxes. So
man,
I get a knife.
I wish I had a stocking job instead of a restaurant. My restaurant sucks. I really want a new job.
Go in.
Unless
Ace nearby, dude.
Unless.
Good job.
You're one of my fellow employees and you're watching, and then I love my job. Great. It's not run very dishevelly and disorganized at all. Oh, no, I keep dropping my random object. Gosh dang. Okay.
I can't see your random object, so.
Oh, well, GG. I will, well,
is it,
neither.
Is it Nathaniel Drake?
Neither will the audio listeners, so I will have to regale.
Is it Nathaniel
everyone.
Drake? Drakenstein?
Drakenstein.
Nathaniel Drakenstein.
What do you think? Of course it is. Hello there, everybody. I'm Nathan Drake.
I make funny jokes on a video game.
Holy crap, guys. Oh, no, okay. But yeah, it's my Drake statue. It's one of my favorite. It's my collectible. It's always up on that shelf right there. It's going to be great. So yeah, that is why I want the collectibles. Collector's edition for Uncharted 4 for sure. Dang it, he fell again.
So
here.
The first item ever
armless
showed.
Nathan Drake. He doesn't have an arm anymore. Look at him.
Oh my
gosh. It's messed
up.
All
right. I can't see this. But yeah, the first item I've ever showed on as the random item was an ice pack. It was
like,
an ice pack.
So I was like, hey, you got anything else to say? And you're like, yeah, ice packs.
Pretty much.
They're cool. They cool your stuff.
Yep.
We're so stupid. So yeah.
Stay fresh.
Stay fresh, everybody. We'll see you next week. Reach out to us if you enjoy the podcast on Twitter. And follow us everywhere else. That is it. Stay fresh.